Well, we all know it's outdated. Gallatin County's plan for a new law and justice center went down in defeat on Election Day.
So now the question becomes, what happens next? MTN's Cody Boyer takes a look at the answer.
According to last night's preliminary numbers, at least with a margin of about 55% to about 45% of voters, that vote that would have upgraded and replaced the Law and Justice Center here failed. For those working here, they fear at the cost of security.
This is a problem that's not going to go away.
For county commissioners like Don Seifert, it's back to the drawing board again.
It's obvious that the voters did not approve this project nor the ones before, and we have to figure out what it is, what project it is that the voters will approve.
And for now, Seifert says there is no plan B.
State law is very clear that for this type of a project, even for a remodel, we would have to go to the voters to approve the dollars for that.
But Seifert adds that's the catch, winning voters over. As a voter, why should a voter care about, especially more about, when we're looking at numbers like this?
This is a project in a building that really serves all of the county. I think there was maybe some confusion about whether or not the city building, duplication of services, that type of thing. This is an entirely different building.
Gallatin County Undersheriff Dan Springer says back to square one could mean years of dealing with old issues.
The fact of bringing inmates in through the public, having contact with witnesses, victims, suspects, all those things, that's always a concern.
It's a concern that he shares with Seifert.
It always boils down to just six words, and that is with liberty and justice for all. This is where our liberties are protected and where justice is served.
Commissioners are working on setting a date to pave a way for the future soon, but are making sure they can get all commissioners to be available to take part.
In Bozeman, Cody Boyer, MTN News.